friends. Myself is Sandeep Vaidyanarayana from M.Tech Bioinformatics. Here I have some doubts. I always used to ask some doubts in the classes. So same doubts I will ask. Yeah, I'm a doubty guy. I'm like that only. The first question from my side is, yes, Rohit had committed suicide. Okay. And something had happened for Rohit. Yes. Be calm. Please, if you make a voice, I can't able to think and talk now. Please, no? And a serious discussion has been taken over across the country, across the world. Even the UN, you might have seen the post that United Nations organization had undergone the report of Rohit Vemula, and they say that there exists serious presence of caste discrimination in the campuses. Right? In such a sense, why don't that even United Nations organization is saying that there exists some caste discriminations in the campuses in the India especially. Why don't we have a cell for discrimination? And one point I want to say that, going back, we got an act called Nirbhaya Act. A girl which had been raped in Delhi roads. But today we don't able to get a Rohit Act. Why? A same challenge I have from very long past, right, you know. So in order to say, like, yes, you may ask, is there truly the caste discriminations in the campuses? I will suggest, please keep inquiries in every NITs, IITs, and also all the campuses, the national campuses, which are there around in India, and take the reports, the mark sheets of the students. Okay? Is it audible for you all? Yeah. Please come. The point I'm saying, like, take out the reports, the mark sheets, the lab reports of all the students from the date of establishment. You can see, arrange them in an ascending order, okay, like topper, this thing, and take from the back, like last time, like out of 100 students, you take 100th name, there will be Sandeep Vaidyanarayana, right, because he's the SCK. The thing is, this type of, my point here is to say that there exists serious caste discriminations in the campuses. So here, you people of University of Hyderabad is ready to take the challenge, and can you open a cell for this particular discrimination? Will you respect? At least you may not mind us. At least you can mind the report of United Nations organization. The complete country is saying that there is discrimination. You are saying that we are doing politics by taking death of Rohit Vemula. I am feeling shy for this.
Democracy, who does not acknowledge the space for democratic engagement in the campus, which we have already seen when the social activists, academicians and media persons were denied access inside the campus. And why we need a vice chancellor, the presence of whom creates fear and intimidation among the a professor, a teacher who does not respect his own colleagues when 20 or 25 professors resign, they given resignation in the academic counseling meeting. Even after that, he continued the meeting, which says that he does not have respect for his own friends, for his own colleagues in fact. So I just request to the entire student community to think on this. Why we need such a vice chancellor? Long live democracy.
I will just be Shankaran. Be Shankaran to be the state leader.
First and foremost, I'd like to say that I'm completely against the stand of having the VC here, that's for sure. And as we students, from the day when Rohit Vemula died, we all were seeking justice, and the atrocious act began right from the day when Rohit died, actually. It is when we were all waiting for the VC to come and apologize. He never came back, and he just sent the police again. And after he came back also, he gave a lathi charge. And one thing is true is that his bail is pending. His interim report has not yet been given. 6 times the bail has been rejected, and still he is coming and sitting with among us. And one more aspect is that he has no respect towards the students. If the students would have been treated properly, today Rohit's death wouldn't have happened today among us. Rohit would have been with us, actually. It's been said that from the time he came, he wanted to control the students. I feel that, yes, he wanted to control, and he diplomatically records a selfie video and puts it on Facebook, saying that please, you all are good boys, as if we are come here with from the Ashirwad of our Ma to come and study here happy. But actually, we have come here to question the Ocean Government. We have come here to think beyond the four walls. We have come here to question what is existing beyond our institution, beyond our caste, and beyond everything. Actually, no matter whether we are outcast or not, I can say. So, and what had happened in the campus issues about the lathi charge? It's clear and evident that the girls were beaten up by the male police and the boys were beaten up by the female police. The footage has been tampered like that, you know about it. And even the footage of the VC long, there has been girls shouts listening everywhere, but the boys' photos everywhere. That is the kind of footage which has been shown for us. So the footage has been tampered terribly. So I request, re-questioning the Moral Policing Act, which the VC speaks about, that whether moral policing should be kept here, because police brutality has already proved that it should never be kept here. And second is that a report should be filed on the police brutality. It should be filed upon what has happened, actually. Whatever is it should be filed. That's what I can say. Thank you.
Now we request Srinivas Indla from Integrated PhD Material Engineering.
Good evening, everybody. Everybody is very sad about this Rohit's death, and I am also very sad. And only one thing means I have few questions to ask our student union. Regarding the, because since I am a PhD student and we are most of the scholars, we don't have any problem with the classes, I think, because we normally go to library and read. But what is the future of the, because after Rohit Vemula, this university has gone a ramp phase, like, you know, the classes were dismissed, and the academic career that our students lost is enormous. And another thing is that if the research scholars would not have been protested, what is the future of the students? The classes would now be resumed. And I want to ask, what are the steps that the student union has taken to resume the classes? And how much long it would have been gone if the protest had not been happened? I want this answer from the student union. Thank you.
Now I request Pritha Soni, MP Sociology, to share
this. All of us already know most of the things, so I will not talk about many facts. But there are two or three very important things that we want to say. One thing that we have noticed throughout is how institutions, laws, structures of the state have been used by Appa Rao, by other people who are involved, by Bandaru Dattatreya, Sushil Kumar and all the other people who are involved to create fear and violence and to suppress the voices. To maintain a certain caste order, to maintain a certain fascist logic, institutions have been used. So I will say something very cliched as an answer to many people asking about procedures and court inquiries, etc. That Holocaust was legal, and even if Appa Rao coming to campus will be legal, will it be acceptable to us? Keeping aside the fact that it is not yet legal, I mean there are students and faculty who are in campus on bail, who were falsely implicated in cases by this administration. But we also have a vice chancellor who is in campus without bail itself. So I mean, another thing about the 22nd, what happened when Grace, Professor Grace's house was raided by this very administration? The answer by the administration that was given is that her house is not a private property. Since it is on campus, it comes under the public institution, and therefore it can be entered into without any kind of permission. But when students take out a protest in the VC lodge, which has been operated as an office, that becomes a private space, and the charges on the students are trespassing in a private. Also, so finally, basically, why is it that we are calling this casteist violence? Why, what is this caste order that is being maintained here is basically, throughout what we see, the way they want to perpetrate violence is to cause fear. By getting police, by suspending students, by punishing them, by giving social boycott as a punishment. The way one understands caste is perpetration of fear. And this is the kind of fear that we are trying to cause. Even in the academic council meeting, the way police came, and I mean everybody knows what is happening. So you see that structurally violence is being perpetrated, fear is being created. This is a marker of caste. This is the evidence that these people are casteist and operate with a fascist mind, and we reject these people. I want to request the student union to take up the agenda of removal of Appa Rao and demanding of arrest of Appa Rao as a part of the UGBL. I just want to end by this statement that जो लड़ना नहीं जानते, जो लड़ना नहीं चाहते, वो गुलाम बनके रह जाते हैं और हम गुलाम नहीं बनेंगे।
Start with some Telugu lines, where the lines shows the significance of the caste discrimination in this society. Neeti kada kulam, kooti kada kulam, kadaku chusukunte kaati kada kulam. The boy starts life with utmost miseries, where he will deny the access to the all public spaces. Even in this 21st century, the same boy, an unappreciated boy like Rohit Vemula, is still being denied of the access to the higher education. This is shame on University of Hyderabad, which again proved that there is a caste, and it also showed that with the effect of the protests and struggles being held by the students of University of Hyderabad, that there is a caste, but we will fight against the caste. Before just I came, one of scholar asked a question to the Students' Union. Maybe I am not a responsible for the person for answering that question, but I am really delighted to share the information regarding the regime of the classes that I think Students' Union, with utmost concern of the student fraternity of this university, negotiated with the interim in charge Vice Chancellor Periaswamy and negotiated with him and managed to get extension of the semester, that this is information. Along with the removal of Vice Chancellor Mr. Appara, and I also put a suggestion to the Students Union that we should also focus a Sanghi Preparatory Board Chairman Mr. Alok Pandey, where that Dronacharya took the finger of Ekalavya, but this modern Dronacharya took the life of our beloved brilliant Dalit scholar, who is Mr. Rohit Vemula. Friends, we know, as he said, as Mr. Appara, who is the Vice Chancellor, even we don't accept. He said that is the 22nd is the black day of the University of Hyderabad. Yes, absolutely, that is the black day. Where a culprit, who is the prime accused in the SCST Prevention of Atrocities Act, he came and he resumed without fearing to the law and order of this country. And on the same day, the so-called register, I'm sorry if I'm very rude, the so-called register, he himself filed some cases against the students, along with the Students Union Vice President Venkatesh Chauhan and ex-Students Union President Danta Prashant and all other students from different departments, filed cases against with the help of some like-minded and LS, I don't know what is LS, like-minded and Chaddiwalas. If at all he believes in the constitution which was handed out by Dr. B. Ambedkar, if at all he respects that, he should also file a conspiracy case against V.C. Apparao and all V.C. Apparao and V.C. Apparao and all those who assisted in selective pickup of the students by selectively giving the names of the students who are peacefully, of course, peacefully protesting in front in the VC lodge. Thank you. Jai Bhim, Neel Saran.